Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Ricky and today I'm going to be showing you how I create this gel wave wet look. This style is becoming increasingly more popular and I've seen very, very few tutorials on it out there and I got a lot of requests to do this tutorial. So please let me know if this helped you, if you enjoyed the video in the comments down below and what I should do next. Without further ado, let's get into it. All right, so I'm starting out with my Dianne Heat Resistant Pintail Comb and I'm just gonna comb my hair. Then I'm gonna start right in the middle of my face and turn it diagonal to the beginning of my brow, and that is where I chose to do my part today. I'm gonna create as clean of a part as possible just by pulling it right across my scalp, the edge of that comb. And so far I'm pretty happy with it, but we'll go in and fix it later. You wanna make sure the part is wide enough so the gel wave will be wide enough when you gel it down. Now I'm just going to start from the back of the part and diagonally pull towards the center of my face until I get a triangle that looks something like this. Then I'm going to fix any imperfections that I need to do in the part to make it as clean as possible. Now that it's parted off, we are just going to tie off the section so it is out of our way when we're doing the ponytail. My hair is really, really super long and I didn't have a clip, so I just had to twist it and use a hairpin to put it in place, but you can use any way that you want to keep your hair out of the way. All right, now that I'm looking pretty funny, I'm just gonna brush my hair, obviously to make it super smooth and as easy to work with as possible. Yes, my hair was super long. I'm gonna use the Tresemme Extra Firm Control Mousse. This is the level 4. I'm taking quite a generous amount and I'm just gonna apply that all over the base of my hair, wherever the ponytail is gonna be slicked back and through my hair as well. Using the same comb, I'm just gonna prep my hair for the first ponytail. It doesn't have to be perfect. You wanna make it pretty sleek, but the most important part is that you make it very, very strong and tight. I'm just using a normal hairband. Just the most important thing is that it's tight. So however you feel, you can get it the tightest is the most important. This is what it is looking like so far. It doesn't have to be perfect, but just make it tight. Now I'm gonna take my Tresemme Level 4 gel. I'm gonna apply quite a bit of this gel over my scalp, literally just pushing it all into my hair so it really, really gets evenly layered throughout the different layers of my hair and not just the top. And I'm gonna take that white comb again and I'm just combing my hair out and I'm putting all the imperfections to the base of the ponytail. I'm also going to be using my hand to smooth over along with the comb to get it as smooth as possible. Now I'm just taking a straight pin and a rubber band and I'm going to take out the normal hairband that I had in. I'm just going to comb it all again so it's nice and sleek. Then I'm going to insert the straight pin into the side of where my new ponytail is going to be. Now it's kind of hard to do on yourself, but you want to hold the pin in the side of the hair and with the other hand you want to wrap the rubber band as many times around as possible until you run out of the rubber band. This should be holding your hair super, super tightly. And if it's possible, you want to try to keep the ponytail as still as you can. Now, once you've done and you've made it to the very, very end, you're just going to take another straight pin and you're just going to secure it into the rubber band. And I really mean into the rubber bands. This is going to keep it much, much stronger and tighter than putting it just across your hair where it's not getting the security from the rubber bands, if that makes sense. It doesn't have to be perfect because we are going to be redoing the ponytail again. Now I'm using my Amped Up teasing comb and I'm just going to use this to smooth over my hair and push all the imperfections towards the base of the ponytail like we did before. This is a very common theme. You're just going to keep doing this until you get the desired result pretty much. I'm using my Tresemme Level 3 hairspray and I'm going to apply a very generous amount, but I would really recommend using the Level 4 or the Level 5 hairspray because the Level 3 is all that I had at my house at that time. Now I'm going to use the teasing comb and my hand to smooth out the imperfections and then blow dry my hair as much as I can to stiffen to help keep the shape once we take out the rubber band. Now that I'm happy with that, I'm going to remove the rubber band by very gently pulling out the two straight pins. You don't want to be too crazy with this because you want to try to keep the shape that you just created with that hairspray and with the hairdryer. So once it's out, I'm gonna use either of my combs to smooth over the imperfections at the base. And now I'm taking two rubber bands and I'm tying them just like I would with a normal hair tie. But at this point, it's super important to keep your ponytail as still as possible so it stays in the middle and there's less stuff to fix later. Now after tying that as tightly as I can, this is what I have so far. Again, I'm not a professional hairstylist, but I think it's pretty good for the base of your ponytail, and you would just want to make it as sleek and smooth as possible. You're going to apply another layer of hairspray. Again, you want to use a really strong layer of hairspray for this because you're going to be locking in the shape for the whole competition day. Do not be afraid. Make sure you're putting a lot, and then using only my hands, especially the palms, I'm going to smooth over my hair to get it super, super sleek, and I'm going to blow dry it one last time to really lock in that shape so it stays that way for the whole day that I'm competing. Now I'm going to wrap the pony, so I'm going to section off some hair. You want to make sure it's not too much or too little. You can experiment with what works for you. And I like to separate the rest of my hair so it's easier to work with, so I just tie a normal ponytail around it. Now I'm going in with my Got to Be Spiking Glue hair gel, and this is really sticky, so I'm going to refer to it as the sticky gel. And then I'm going to go in with my Tresemme Level 5 control gel, which is what we used in the beginning. And since this is really liquidy, I'm going to refer to it as my liquid gel. Now I'm going to start with going underneath the ponytail to slowly and carefully wrap this around those rubber bands. I tried going above and it really didn't work, and every time I do this I find that going underneath is much better. So I'm going to flatten and smooth the hair with every wrap that I do until I run out of hair. This is really, really important that you're smoothing it out and keeping it as flat as possible because we don't want it to be lumpy there. We want it to be as sleek as we can get it. Now once we're at the end, the hair should be sticky enough to stick to the rest of the hair without needing a hairpin. Of course, we're just going to smooth it over to make it look like one piece, and I'm going to do a hairspray, hairspray, hairdry to lock it in place for the entire day. Now, of course, this is not perfect, but it is pretty good and it is very sleek and tight. It will stay in and there were no pins. Now you can straighten your hair if you need to, but this is what I have right now. Just a basic Latin ponytail, and now we are going to move on to the gel wave part. So I'm gonna take it out, and of course my hair is not looking very pretty right now, so you can straighten this part again if you need to, but I just combed my hair out and I started combing it in the direction that I'm going to do the wave, and now I'm going to mix those two gels again. So I'm gonna use my Got to Be Glued Spiking Gel, and I'm gonna put this from the very top to the bottom, pretty generous amount. You really want to make sure all of the hair is covered. And yes, I added a little bit extra, and even though it's better to add extra and then remove the excess, which is what I'm doing right now. So I'm gonna comb out the excess gel. Trust me, there will be excess gel. And since this glue, this hair glue is literally so sticky, it made my hair very stringy, which is why I'm gonna use the liquidy gel to mix with it to give back that flexibility. And for me, it ends up being kind of the perfect combo. I'm just coating it from the top to the bottom, keeping my hair wide and flat. As you can see, I have a very long piece of hair to work with. And now I'm gonna start creating the shape. So basically here, you just have to play around with it. It's likely you won't have the perfect wave on the first try, and that's okay. I never do. It's just important to play with the shape and work with the hair so you get a feel for it to see what is working for you that day. For an example, I liked this shape, but my hair is so long, of course I couldn't do that, so I had to restart it, recomb it out, try again, and now I'm flattening and pulling down my hair with 1 to 2 fingers and just kind of forming the first loop, and I'm going to form the loops much tighter and closer together so I can fit all my hair on my face. Now, I'm kind of working quickly, as you can see, to create a rough draft of what it's going to look like, and I'm going to keep flattening out the hair as I work with it. This is very important to keep flattening it out. The combo of the sticky and the wet gels should be able to help stick to the base with the flexibility to help shape the hair as you go along. So now, as you can see, I'm just pressing and shaping my hair to kind of complete my rough draft of what my wave is going to look like. And now you can see that I've successfully fit all of my hair, so I can move on to the next step, which is going to be flattening and pressing the wave to create a wider and more flattering shape. So I'm widening the hair, as you can see, as much as possible. You want to be gentle so you don't mess up the shape that you already created, but you want to keep pressing it, keep making it wider to the way that you like it. Now, as I was trying to widen the last loop, I ended up accidentally separating the hair. So I decided to gently pull that section off and redo it. But since the hair was stringy from the sticky gel, I added more of my wet gel, which made the hair stick together really, really easy. So it was nice and flexible to work with again. And I repositioned it and started making it wider as I was applying it on my face and making sure all the hair was still sticking together. At the very, very end, I kind of cheated a little bit. I just attached the very end of my hair to that first loop, and now I flattened and widened that end shape again to kind of match with the first bigger loops towards the top of my head. And you just have to keep playing with it and keep playing with it until you get to your liking. Now I'm using a very generous amount of hairspray, and I would recommend either of these two hairsprays. You just want it to be really, really strong hairspray. You're just going to apply a lot of this, and I'm going to flatten and continue to create my shape with the consistency of the hairspray to really keep it flexible and lock it in place with more hairspray and with blow drying. And you want to do this in layers. So you're going to do hairspray, blow dry at least 2 times. That is going to lock it in place so it stays for the entire competition and you don't have any worries of it coming out. This is my final product, you guys. Of course, this is not perfect. This is just what worked for me. I tried to show all the helpful techniques that I could on how I achieved this on myself. I really hope you enjoyed this video.
All right, you guys, this is the completed tutorial. I really hope that you enjoyed this video and that you've learned something new. Please let me know in the comments down below if you really liked it and what I should do next. I'm pretty happy with the way it came out. I don't do a lot of gel waves, and definitely there are way, way, way better gel waves out there that I see scrolling on Instagram or in competition that I would love to learn how to do. This is just the version that I know how to do, and I wanted to show you guys how I do that. If you want to keep up with all my posts and tutorials, go ahead and follow me at Ricky T Beauty. That's going to be on Facebook, Instagram, and TikTok. I post loads of photos and videos on there of all my looks, and I actually do post quite a bit exclusive Instagram and TikTok videos that I do not post here on YouTube on my makeup looks. So there's a lot of cool looks over there that you can check out if you want to. Other than that, I hope you have a great rest of your night or day wherever you are, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.